morning, FHS, and welcome to the last Tiger News show of this trimester. I'm Alex Robinson.
And I'm Cora Cobb.
We have an amazing teacher here at FHS and here at Tiger News. This is Mr. Toutge's 13th year at Farmington High School, and he has seen many changes in the television and radio broadcasting department. This week, we take a look inside the news and Mr. Toutge's motivation to bring it all to a new level.
Hey Farmington, this is Alex Robinson. You've all seen Tiger News, but do you really know what it takes to make a show, or the man behind it all? I had a chance to sit down with Mr. Toutge and ask him a few questions. What made you want to pursue a career in video production?
The thing that made me want to pursue video production was when I was about 12 years old, I kind of knew that I wanted to be involved in radio and audio and television and video production. I'd observe radio stations and watch TV and thought it was really, really cool. I thought, man, if I could do that for a job, that would be so cool. Like, probably wouldn't work a day in my life. So I really got interested when I was about 12 years old, watching radio announcers and TV people.
Who are some of the more talented individuals to come to Tiger News?
We also have quite a few successful people coming out of Farmington High School just recently. Ben Erb has the most unbelievable radio voice I think I've ever heard. Anytime that we have something that we need, like really good sounding audio, I go to Ben and say, Ben, I need this done. Ben is always willing to do it. He'll be going to St. Cloud State next year. Last year, we were really challenged with Charlie Werke. He was one of our best students that we've ever had. He wanted to know more, do more. What can I do to make myself shine when he got to college and basically out in broadcasting world? Just pleasant guy. I know he's gonna do really, really well. He's got such a great future ahead of him.
I also got to sit down with Charlie and I asked him, what is Mr. Toutge's message to his students?
He really wants to like push for the best out of everyone, and he knows what we can all be capable of if we work hard and get our packages done. And as soon as you get that perfect show and you get everything together and you know you did a good job and you start walking through the halls and everybody's telling you how awesome the new show was, I think that's where he really gets his sense of accomplishment, and that's where he really feels like he got everything done the way he wanted to.
Mr. Toutge, why are you so passionate about Tiger News?
All of these rooms, when we moved down here, they were empty. There wasn't one piece of equipment in any of these rooms except for when we brought all the equipment back from Bachman. This is all the old equipment from Bachman Middle School, which was the old high school. All of these rooms were empty, and one of the biggest things for me is I wired this whole entire place from the ground up, and I'm really, really proud of that. I think the students have appreciated all the technology that they've got their hands on, and we're having fun. It's a teamwork place. When you go to a TV station or a radio station, you've got teamwork.
So there you have it, Farmington. Alex Robinson signing off for Tiger News.
Thanks, Alex. Mr. Toutge is a fabulous teacher, and I think everybody should come try out one of his classes.
Definitely.
Yeah. Attention seniors, tell us where you have applied for college by entering this information into Naviance and then be eligible for a mystery prize drawing. Deadline for the entries is December 10th.
One cheerleader proved that beauty truly is the eye of the beholders. Megan M., a cheerleader for the Indianapolis Colts, made a remarkable move Sunday when she shaved her head in front of 60,000 screaming fans. Megan made a bet with the team's mascot, Blue, that if they were able to raise $10,000 for their team's cancer relief charity, Chuck Strong, by the 25th, she would shave her head. Since then, a shocking $22,000 was raised, and the cheerleader kept her promise. Upon seeing Megan shave her head, fellow cheerleader Krista Ann joined in and lost her hair for the cause.
Wow, the players that they cheer on must be really strong.
Definitely, and if you want to be strong like those football players, Logan Haykana is here to give you the inside scoop about weight training with Mr. Winant.
IFHS, this is Logan Hakana reporting for Tiger News. Andrew Lipkowski here doing the power clean, which works with explosiveness.
Here we are with Max Aldana doing Spartan pull-ups, which works your lats.
I mean, you always got to put in effort. I mean, you got to really want it. You know, I mean, we have this weight room. You can always come down after school.
As far as classes that you can take here at the high school, you can start in ninth grade. Fitness for Life is the first class that will use the weight room a couple times a week. As you progress into Phi Ed, you can take sports conditioning, which is also in the weight room twice a week. We use the track, we use the gyms. If you really like to concentrate on the weight room and strength training period, weight training, we offer three different sections of that, weight training 1, 2, and 3. And then the final class for that utilizes the weight room a lot is Senior Health Club, which you can take as a senior. So there's a lot of different options you can take. Also, if you're not able to take the class or you've already taken the courses and you still want more, after school, we have an open weight room.
What are the benefits of working out?
Well, scientifically, there's a lot of benefits both physically and mentally. You know, there's a lot of studies out there that show that a physically fit person is a not only physically healthier person, but mentally and emotionally as well. There's a lot of studies that have shown in schools that a more fit student is a better student. My own personal experiences, I got into working out a lot in high school. We had weight training programs and stuff like that. I did it for athletics. My coach just kind of pushed me to do that. So that was the benefit back then for me. But then it also kind of taught me habits and good, healthy habits that I continued throughout college and you know, to current day. So, you know, just staying physically fit is a big part of my life.
Being fit is a part of my life also, and it should be a part of yours. We hope to see you in the weight room. I'm Logan Kana, reporting for Tiger News. Back to you in the studio.
You know, Alex, do you get in the weight room often?
You know, I do, and I'm recently pretty sore.
Yes, and it's a very good opportunity. We hope to see a lot more people in the weight room.
Many people consider the movie Up to be a classic that introduced us to a strange new world full of surprises and mystery. But one key aspect of the film has become a reality. National Geographic, as a part of their new show, How Hard Can It Be?, have recreated the famous balloon-powered floating house. Hundreds of 8-foot weather balloons helped raise the 2,000-pound brick house into the skies. Not only did they accomplish the task of lifting the house off the ground, but they also set a new record for the largest balloon cluster flight ever attempted.
Alex, did you ever have Mr. Stock as a teacher?
I did not, but in eighth grade he was a football coach.
He was my football coach in eighth grade as well. And then my teacher in ninth grade. We now go with Lindsay Foster to take an inside look at the life of Mr. Stock.
That's Mr. Stock in that yearbook. He says he enjoyed his time here as a student.
In high school, I did a lot of stuff. I played football.
Mr. Stock was awesome, really awesome. Why? Because he was very athletic and he was very coachable.
I was a part of the snowboarding club or the ski club, but I snowboarded. I played tennis for a year. I did track a couple of years. I was in the marching band. Back then, everybody in band was in the marching band, but it was a lot of fun. Enjoyed video games. I still play a video game from time to time. My favorite thing to read is The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. I probably read that book 24 times, the whole series. This year I teach English 9 and English 11. My favorite thing about Farmington is the people. Farmington's full of some of the nicest people in the whole world. Dozens of people ready to help you out, willing to do anything they need them to do.
Lindsay Foster reporting for Tiger News.
Thanks, Lindsay. Mr. Stock is a great teacher. I had him as a teacher last year.
Yes, he is. And now Max, going into winter sports, especially with that weightlifting, I saw you in that video. You're getting pretty big.
I know. I've been working really hard, been getting jacked and cutter. You've had some good results, too. You're getting there, but I'll help you out a little bit in the winter, okay? So, we'll start sports off today with a little bit of college football news. The Big Ten Conference is expanding once again after just 2 years when the Big Ten expanded to 12 schools with the addition of Nebraska. Maryland and Rutgers will become the 13th and 14th teams in the Big Ten Conference, starting the 2014 through 2015 academic school year. This week in college football, it's conference championship week. The matchups include rematches of number 16 UCLA versus number 8 Stanford in the Pac-12 championship, and number 12 Nebraska versus Wisconsin, the Big Ten championship game. The most anticipated matchup of these games is number 2 Alabama against number 3 Georgia in the SEC conference championship. The winner of this game will take on Notre Dame in the national title game. And then there's the Vikings. This past week, they played for the Bears and lost 28-10. The Vikings now have a record of 6-5 and have lost 4 of their last 6 games, heading in this week's game against the Green Bay Packers. That's it for sports news this week. And my sports shout-out goes to the basketball manager, Dom Padawano, and my fellow anchor, Carter Bloomster.
Thanks for the sports update, Max.
Yes, thank you. Have you ever wanted to work for the Apple Store at the Genius Bar? Well, now you can. Kind of. With the addition of iPads arriving in the hand of each high school student before the holiday break, we have an important announcement to share with you, Mr. Duarte, District 192, Head of District Technology.
Hi, my name is Charles Duarte. I'm the Head of Instructional Technology for Farmington Area Public Schools, and I'm looking for your help. We're looking for students who can help us as volunteers and man the inner genius bar that will be located here at the high school. The primary role will be to support those who need help with their iPads and support in the area of technology. What we're looking for is inner genius bar staff so that they can be there before and after school, Monday through Thursday. We're also looking for a time commitment on December 18th, 19th, and 20th as we have families and students come in to receive their iPads. In order to apply for this, we'd like you to submit a brief letter of interest and a resume including 2 references. You do not need to have letters of recommendation for this purpose. One of the perks to this position is you will be a part of the first group to receive iPads, actually before any other Farmington High School students receive them. Please submit your brief letter of interest, your resume, including 2 references, to cduarte@farmington.k12.mn.us. Thank you, and I look forward to your applications.
Hi, I'm Laura.
I'm Brooke.
And I'm Jen.
And we're the wrestling cheerleaders.
You should come join wrestling and basketball cheerleading.
If you're tired of sitting in the stands and you want to cheer on your team, come to the old kindergarten center next Monday after school and come learn the cheers and support your favorite team. Boys and girls are both welcome.
There are no tryouts. You can just come and be part of a team. It's a lot of fun.
It's a lot of fun, so come and join us.
Let's go over to weather with Travis.
Hello, Farmington. I'm your weatherman, Travis Apple. Behind me is a green screen, which I use to show you the weather. Now, when my weather comes up, you're going to see some awesome things.
Travis, there's no weather.
So, actually, I don't really feel like showing you the weather this week, but we're going to see some pretty good days. It's going to be like the 50s. Not really a big chance of snow. There's going to be some cold things happening going on, but overall it's going to be a pretty good week. Now let's keep going on here and cut it back to those guys in the studio. Back to you guys.
Well, thank you, Travis, for that wonderful update.
Thanks anyways, Travis. Well, you've all seen Brian and Kelly's interviewing your fellow classmates and teachers, but for this week's What Do You Think, we go behind the scenes to check out the What Do You Think bloopers.
What do you think?
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 Just be honest, but don't be vulgar. What do you... what do you guys think of the new high school? Sorry. And we got a bear and a dog and a,
No. We should do this fast because people are going to think I'm like taking a dump. I'm at the bathroom right
now. Okay, we're...
I wish I could be a cheetah.
Okay, yeah.
There it is. This is all going to be in bloopers.
As soon as this machine leaves.
I'm obviously in the band. No, I quit this one. This is
no.
Bad. Okay. Yeah, I don't like going.
Okay, ready? Is it on?
And sometimes me and my brother, we like to watch sci-fi movies like Mutants Kill.
Describe your perfect date, Catherine.
Wow, that's really interesting.
That's great. Thank you so much.
Oh, are we at your news?
Oh. Can I hold it? No, you can't hold it. Should we get her? Okay, Emma.
What are your guys' favorite scary movies?
What's your favorite scary? Yeah.
Oh my god, I'm on the spot. I can't do this.
I can't do this. Let me interview you.
I'm gonna be a cowgirl.
Yeah. Okay.
Next.
Pause it. Pause it real fast. Can you pause it?
I never
Hello, asked. Brian.
I never get gas.
What are you gonna be for Halloween now?
I'm gonna be Scream.
Thanks, everyone. Stop!
I'm alive.
Thanks to all the freshen. Freshen?
This week's question is, if you could be any animal, what would you...
We think of pumpkin!
The cries are...
Hey, guys! Oh, hi.
Hi, I'm Brian Waldblink. We're gonna die.
Okay.
Oh my god.
We're gonna die.
Hi. Here you go. Oh my gosh, it's wet! What do you have to say, goats? Oh my gosh, you're, oh, that one's really ugly. Oh, look at it. You're mean. You scared away all your friends.
You billy goat grouse!
I'm like more hyper than you. I'm louder than you, okay?
Hi!
I need to do a shout out to Ally Pingley from The Office.
Why do we do this for Tiger News? We already have Renee.
California girls, unforgettable. Daisy Duke's bikinis on.
I wanna see Daisy. Think.
This thing is not on.
Thank you, Brian and Kelly. It's been a great trimester, and I've enjoyed every package that you guys have delivered to us.
Yes, thank you very much. Now, as we move into girls swimming, Michael Fox took a little inside look at the state tournament.
Hey FHS, this is Michael Fox, reporting for the Farmington girls swim team.
We've had a really great season. Our team is really a family. We come together. They work their butts off every day in practice. There's a lot of talented girls. They're very driven, motivated, and they help encourage each other too. So that's exciting as well. Caitlin O'Reilly actually was named the Section Swimmer of the Year, which is a first for a Farmington swimmer, so that's very exciting.
What's it like to go to state for swimming?
High school state since eighth grade year I've gone, and club state since I was 8 years old. It's kind of unlike anything. It's a lot of hype around it. Everybody's really excited. There's a lot of nerves with it, but you usually just get past it, and you can ride off the energy of the crowd, off every other swimmer. It's just super exciting to be there. It's pretty tough training. Everybody works really hard. We usually are breathing pretty heavily red-faced at the end, and we practice 5 times a week, and that's just in the afternoons, and then we have 2 or 3 morning practices every week from 5 o'clock till school starts.
It's a fun sport, but it's very hard. It's very aerobic based, meaning your heart rate's up for about 2.5 hours the whole time from practice. But they have a lot of fun. They're quirky and they have a good time together. So I enjoyed the camaraderie, the teamwork, the atmosphere, the competition. And that's what I think these girls get out of it too. You know, so the seniors I've worked with for 6 years, and I've gotten to know them on a personal level, and have really enjoyed watching them grow into young women. And it's fun to see them develop both in the pool and in life. So
Michael Fox reporting for Tiger News. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thank you so much, Michael.
Thank you. Well, it's been a great time giving you the news this try, and a lot went really well, but here's a look at some of the times things didn't go quite according to plan.
You went on that one.
Finally, on Saturday, did you watch the debate on Wednesday night?
Yeah, I did.
That's awesome.
Mm-hmm. By the way, like your hair today, you look pretty good.
Thank you, man.
Look sharp. All right.
A low of 25, partly cloudy. Saturday we'll have a high.
Yeah, we got a lot of big news coming up, so it's busy. All right, so.
That's pretty cool, Cora.
Mm-hmm. And before we get into sports, your hair continues to wow me. It's amazing.
Thanks, Alex.
We'll be right back after this.
So Cora, do you have a dog?
I do have a dog.
What's your dog's name?
Maggie Jade.
It's a cute name. Yeah. I don't have a dog.
What did you bring on an island, sir?
I don't want to answer a question.
All right.
You sure? Okay.
Eagles, back to you guys at the studio.
And bro, Max, what do we got for sports, bro?
Well, bro, we got a lot going on, bro, and you should check out the Valley game, bro.
I won't but be able to go. I'm haunting, guys.
On that note,
who's actually counting the votes?
I don't know what to do with my hands here.
And delivers a great pass to Tip Dittman. Touchdown Tigers.
So, that's probably all we have for Tiger News today, I'd have to say.
Yeah, that's some good medical stuff, some doctor stuff. And that's it for Tiger News today. I'm Max Aldana.
I'm Cora Cobb.
I'm Carter Bloomster.
And I'm Travis Apple.
We're gonna go live to the College and Career Center.
I'm good, Sydney, how are you? How's everything in the College and Career Center?
It's awesome. I'm here with Miss Walker today in the College and Career Center. So can you tell us more about the College and Career Center?
Sydney, we're here in the College and Career Center. It's open every day.
But first, Max, are you participating in No Shave November?
Why, yes I am, and it's going well, but could be better.
As you can barely see, I am actually participating, so.
Well, that's a good looking stash you're gonna get started with. Anyway.
Sunday, there's a chance of rain. And a great day to sit inside and read a book. I'd love to tell you what Monday's weather is. It's really dark. Oh, now, okay.
And we got Thanksgiving Day, partly cloudy.
Low 40, Thanksgiving, eat some turkey.
So what are you doing for Thanksgiving?
You know, I'm gonna go to my grandma's house and eat some turkey. What about you?
I'm gonna go to Wisconsin.
That's fun. Back to you guys.
Farmington girls volleyball finished 14-15 overall. Well,
that's it for the show this week.
I'm Kelsey Smith.
I'm Cora Cobb.
I'm Sydney Bockelman.
I'm Heather Barnes.
I'm
Lindsay Foster.
We leave you today.
Goes to the Beast, and he's back. The Beast is back. All right.
Our hearts, oh, the pouring rain. We'll try to put it out,
brightly burst into a million sparks that all disperse and illuminate a world that'll try to bring you down, but not this time. When the sun goes down and the lights burn out, then it's time for you to shine brighter than a shooting star. So shine no matter where you are. Fill the darkest night with a brilliant light, 'cause it's time for you to shine brighter than a shooting star. So shine no matter where you are tonight. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Brighter than a shooting star. Shine no matter where you are tonight. A thousand heartbeats beat in time and makes this dark planet come alive. So when the lights flicker out tonight, you gotta shine.
Section of Tiger News is over. There's a lot of people to thank. The entire background of the cast, all the anchors, Brian and Kelly, for their amazing jobs. And for one last time on Tiger News.
It's very emotional for me, but I'm your sports anchor, Max.
I'm Carter Bloomster.
I'm Sydney Bachelman.
I'm Alex Robinson.
I'm Cora Cobb.
Or what do you think?
Or what do you think, Brian Welbilick and Kelly Elmer?
I'm kind of your weatherman, Travis.
Thanks for watching this trimester. I hope you have a good rest of the week and good luck on your finals. Thank you.
Bye. Bye.